I'm Adi Belenes. Welcome to St. Mary Dedication British International Online Class. Today we are going to look at physics. This class for SS1, and our topic today is calculation involving electric fields. So under this topic, we are going to look at different formulas and relations used in resistors and capacitors in electric fields and electric circuits, calculations involving resistors in circuits, and calculations involving capacitors in a circuit. So these are the important formulas and relations that we need. It can either be in series or in parallel. In series, we add all the resistors together to get the total resistance. ROT here represents the total resistance. Okay, RO1 is a unit, a resistance. A resistor, actually, this is another resistor. That's another resistor. Actually, they say you can have more than one resistors. So when we have like five resistors, we are going to have from RO1 to RO5. But sometimes the resistors can also be arranged in parallel. In this case, we apply this simple formula, 1 over ROT. So we have 1 over ROT is equal to 1 over ROT1 plus 1 over ROT2 plus 1 over ROT3. Also, we also have capacitors in series in a circuit. For these, when they are in series, we do 1 over CT. CT is the effective capacitance, okay? So when we have like three capacitors in a circuit, we have 1 over C1 plus 1 over C2 plus 1 over C3. Also, capacitors can also be in parallel. In this case, we add all the capacitors together to get the total or effective resistance. Okay, before we continue, the effective resistance is also known as the total resistance. Same with the effective capacitance, it's known as the total capacitance or the net capacitance. Then they are all the same rules. Okay, now let's look at example 1 on resistors. Now we have three resistors in a circuit, they are arranged in series. Okay, so if you observe something carefully, these three resistors are drawn with a single conductor. So we can see that these three resistors are in series. Okay, so now we are asked to find the effective resistance in this circuit. So applying the formula, we have ROT is equal to RO1 plus RO2 plus ROT3. The RO1 is 1 ohms, RO2 is 2 ohms, and RO3 is 3 ohms. So we add them together. So finally, our total is ROT, which is the effective resistance, is equal to 6 ohms. Now, for 2, we have 3 resistors. They are arranged in parallel. And if you observe carefully, the resistors are not connected together by a single wire. Okay? So what we are seeing here is that we have a junction, a point here, another point here, and these resistors are both joined end to end, okay? End to end to this point, end to end to that point. So in this type of setup, we say that, so when the resistors are in parallel, we apply this formula 1 over ROT. This equals 1 over RO1 plus 1 over RO2 plus 1 over RO3. So the two resistors are equivalent, that is, they are equal. So just go and write 1 plus 1 over 2 plus 1 over 2 plus 1 over 2. Now, if you observe this fraction, okay, the denominators are equal. Okay, so we take one of them, which is 2. Okay, since they have equal denominators, what we just do is that we add the numerators together. The numerators here are 1 for each fraction. So 1 plus 1 plus 1 is what? 3. So this equals to 3 over 2. So what we have solved so far here is actually 1 over ROT. 1 over ROT, which is 1 over the total resistance. What we are required here is to get ROT not 1 over ROT. So we find the reciprocal. Reciprocal means turn it upside down. Okay, so now we have 3 over 2 initially, so we turn it upside down, so we are going to end up with 2 over 3 ohms. Okay, for number 3, we have a slight interesting combination here. These two resistors are in series, okay, and these two resistors in series are in parallel to this third resistor. So we have two resistors in series connected to the third resistor in parallel. So for this case, we add these two resistors in series, then we now add the parallel to the cell resistor. Okay, so this is our formula. I'm adding the resistors in series, 1 and 2 in series. So we are actually going to use the formula involving resistors in parallel. These two resistors in parallel to the cell resistor. That's what R1, R2 in parallel to R3. R1, R2 in parallel to R3. So we have 1 over R3 is equal to 1 over R1 plus R2 plus 1 over R3. Okay? In series, we just add the two resistors together. Okay? We add the two resistors together. So 2 ohms plus 2 ohms will give us 4. So we have 1 over 4. R1 plus R2 is 4. Now, plus 1 over 2 is the third resistor there. Okay? So now we have 1 over 4 plus 1 over 2. This is a fraction. So, as usual, when we have a fraction, the first thing we do is that we look for the LCM. The LCM of 4 and 2 is 4. Okay?